Thank you very much for accessing part one of the TPS6598X Application Customization GUI Tool video series. You can download the GUI software at the link shown below. This video will walk you through the GUI's purpose and terms, the user interface, project and binary savings, and the help menu. For the rest of the video series, we will refer to the Application Customization GUI Tool as the GUI. The GUI is a Windows-based tool which can be used with the TPS6598X family of PD controllers for changing configuration settings and interacting with PD controllers over I2C. I2C interaction is used for debugging and real-time host interface interaction, as well as field programming of external spy flash. Some of the common GUI terms used are listed below. A project file is a file type that the GUI uses to edit configuration settings and create binaries. Configuration settings are registers that the GUI allows you to edit, and the firmware-based image is a device-specific RAM firmware. The start page is displayed after launching the GUI. Upon opening the GUI, there is no project loaded and there are limited menu options. There are also no configuration settings and no firmware-based image. When beginning a new project, you can open a default project. The default projects cover primary use cases for all TPS6598X applications. Click the Project tab in the menu, then select New Project from the drop-down menu. The pop-up window will allow you to select and open a default project. Select the device to be used. Next, select the project type. TI recommends using the standard option. Next, select the port type of the design to complete the new project setup. After opening a project, you will have access to the menu options not displayed when the GUI did not have a project. One important thing to note is the Port Settings tab. The Port Settings tab gives access to the configuration settings that you can edit. Another thing to note is that the GUI now contains a firmware-based image that is device-specific. The GUI allows you to save different types of binary files. The low region binary can be used to perform a field update of the external flash memory and consists of the configuration settings and the firmware base image. The full flash image is directly flashable to the external flash memory. It has a header, the low region binary, and a redundant copy of the low region called the high region. To save the different types of binary files, click on the binary menu, then select Save Binary. Next, check the box with your desired file type. Then add in the appropriate file destinations by selecting Change File and select OK to save the binary. To save the project, click on the Project menu and select Save Project. Next, change the file to the appropriate file destination and select OK. Alternative to creating a new project, you can also load a previous project into the GUI. If the GUI version being used is the same as the previous project's GUI version, select the Project tab, then select Load Project and choose the previous project from its file location. If the project is from a different GUI version, first create a new project or load a project. This will allow you to then import the settings from the previous project. Keep in mind that you cannot import settings from a project file of a different device family. The application will not allow the import action. Next, we will talk about finding help and the help menu. In port settings, you can hover over a configuration setting for more detailed information about that setting. The help menu has the About tab to provide more information on the GUI. The GUI version is listed as well as the release date. The Supported Devices section lists each device with the GUI's corresponding firmware patch version. The description of the changes made in each GUI release can also be found here. For more information on the difference between the firmware patches, navigate to the Documents tab and select your device's firmware release notes. These will provide a history of the bugs that were fixed through the patches. Additionally, the Application Customization Tool User's Guide will provide more in-depth description of how to use the GUI. Thank you for watching the GUI Basics video. Please check out our other videos in the GUI video series.